हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सिंपल मैथ्स टेक्निक्स। ई चैनल मेरो फर्स्ट टाइम చూస్తున్నట్లయితే ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ టు మై ఛానల్।
ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ టుడే వి డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ హౌ టు మెమరైజ్ ఇంటిగ్రేషన్ ఫార్ములాస్ ఆఫ్ ట్రిగనోమెట్రిక్ రేషియోస్ ఇన్ ఈజీ వే। సో వి నో దట్ dy/dx ఆఫ్ sin x ఈక్వల్స్ టు cos x। సో ద ఇంటిగ్రేషన్ is the reverse process of differentiation, so we integrate cos x, you can get sin x। So integration of cos x dx equals to simply we write sin x plus c। So we know the another formula dy/dx of cos x equals to minus sin x। So here integration of sin x dx equals to minus cos x plus c। So we know the two formulas, integration of cos x dx equals to sin x plus c and integration of sin x dx equals to minus cos x plus c। Using these two formulas, how to write the two integration tan x dx and integration cot x dx formulas? So first of all, integration of tan x dx equals to using sin x formula, integration of tan x dx equals to, so integration of sin x dx equals to minus cos x, so integration of tan x dx equals to minus log cos x। So the formula of integration of tan x dx equals to minus log cos x, or take minus 2 this side, it becomes cos x whole power minus 1, so here it becomes log of 1 by cos x, that is log secant x। So simply we memorize the formula integration of tan x dx equals to minus log cos x using the formula m log a, that is log a power m, so you can write log cos x whole power minus 1, then log cos x whole power minus 1 value is log 1 by cos x, so 1 by cos x value is log secant x। So integration of tan x dx have two formulas, one is minus log cos x or log secant x plus c। Now integration of cot x dx, so using the formula integration of cos x dx, that is equals to sin x plus c, so integration of cot x dx formula is log sin x plus c। So we write integration of tan x dx formula using sin x dx, integration of cot x dx formula using integration of cos x dx simply। So observe the table secant x plus tan x, here secant x we write two times and write plus symbol and tan x, cosecant x, so here also we write cosecant x two times minus and cot x, so clearly we observe that table। Now you can write using the table, you can write these formulas, integration of secant square x dx, here secant square x means secant x into secant x, so use here, see the table, secant x into secant x, remaining we have plus tan x, so integration of secant square x dx formula is tan x plus c। So now the second formula, integration of cosecant square x dx, so cosecant square x dx means cosecant x into cosecant x, remaining we have minus cot x plus c। Now see the third formula, integration of secant x into tan x dx, so here secant x into tan x, remaining we have plus secant x, so integration of secant x tan x dx value is secant x plus c। So integration of cosecant x into cot x dx formula is integration of cosecant x into cot x, cosecant x into cot x, remaining we have minus cosecant x, so minus cosecant x plus c। So fifth formula, integration of secant x into dx, integration of secant x into dx, so here integration of secant x into dx, remaining we have secant x plus tan x. So here we can write log of secant x plus tan x plus c. So integration of cosecant x dx equals to, so integration of cosecant x dx, remaining we have cosecant x minus cot x. So you can write log of cosecant x minus cot x plus c. So hi viewers, so simply we write these formulas using this table. Now we see how to memorize some simple functions of integration easy way. So integration of x power n dx equals to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So using this formula, you can write simply integration of f of x whole power n into f dash x dx. Here we observe it, here we have f of x instead of x, and also we have the derivative of f of x, that is f dash x into dx. So integration of f of x whole power n into f dash x dx. So now you can write using this formula, that is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So you can write f of x whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So integration of 1 by x dx equals to log x plus c. We know the formula. You can use this formula. You can write integration of f dash x by f of x plus c. So here you can write integration of 1 by f of x into f dash x dx. So see that here we have f of x instead of x. So, and also we have the derivative of f of x dx. So you can write log f of x plus c. You can write some simple functions f of ax plus b. So first of all, you can see the formula integration of ax plus b whole power n dx. So we know the formula integration of x power n dx equals to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Using this formula, you can write it. So first of all, you can write it, the x coefficient a here in the denominator, that is 1 by a. Now you can write x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Here we have ax plus b instead of x, so you can write ax plus b whole power n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So the second formula, integration of 1 by ax plus b dx. Here we have, first of all, you can write the x coefficient in denominator, that is x coefficient of a is a, so 1 by a into, so here it is 1 by ax plus b dx. So here integration of 1 by x dx equals to log x. So we know that we have ax plus b instead of x. You can write log of ax plus b plus c. So see the next formula, integration of e power ax plus b dx. Here also we can write the x coefficient, that is a, so 1 by a. So e power x dx formula is e power x plus c. So you can write e power, instead of x you can write ax plus b plus c. So integration of a power bx plus c. Here first of all write x coefficient, that is 1 by b into a power, integration of a power x dx equals to a power x by log a plus c. So here also you can write a power, instead of x we have bx plus c by log a plus c. So plus k, here the constant value plus k. Next you can write integration of sine of ax plus b dx. So first of all write x coefficient in the denominator, that is 1 by a, into integration of sin x dx formula is minus cos x. So you can write minus and cos of, instead of x we have ax plus b, so ax plus b plus c. Next, integration of cos of ax plus b dx. First of all you can write the x coefficient in the denominator, that is 1 by a, into integration of cos of ax plus b dx, that is sin of ax plus b plus c. So integration of secant square of ax plus b dx, so that is x coefficient is 1 by a into secant square of ax plus b dx, that is tan of ax plus b plus c. Integration of cosecant square of ax plus b dx, here also x coefficient is a, that is 1 by a into integration of cosecant square x dx, formula is minus cot x, so minus cot of, instead of ax we have ax plus b plus c. So integration of secant of ax plus b into tan of ax plus b dx. So here, first of all, you can write x coefficient in the denominator, that is 1 by a. Integration of secant x tan x value secant x. So into secant of x value is ax plus b plus c. So 1 by a into secant of ax plus b plus c. So next formula, integration of cosecant of ax plus b into cot of ax plus b dx. So first of all, write x coefficient, that is 1 by a into integration of cosecant x into cot x dx, value is minus cosecant x plus c. So minus cosecant of x value is ax plus b plus c. So the formula is minus 1 by a into cosecant of ax plus b plus c. Now we discuss 9 standard integrals easy way. So before that, how many types you can write x square and a square using plus and minus signs? So now you can see that first of all, a square plus x square or x square plus a square, so both are same. Now a square minus x square and x square minus a square, so we can write using x square and a square terms, plus and using plus and minus, 3 types. Now you can write using these 3 terms, 1 by a square plus x square, 1 by a square minus x square, 1 by x square minus a square. So here also we get another 3 terms. Now you can write roots, using roots, root of a square plus x square, root of a square minus x square, root of x square minus a square, and 1 by root of a square plus x square, 1 by root of a square minus x square, 1 by root of x square minus a square. So here 3 terms and here also another 3 terms. So total 12 terms you can write using x square and a square. So but the first 3 terms we directly integrate these values, but we did not directly integrate the another 9 values. So now you can write the formulas of these 9 values. So these are familiar in integration, 9 standard of integrals. Now you can write the formulas of these 9 standard integrals. So now we write the formula, integration of 1 by a square plus x square dx. Observe it. We know the formula, integration of 1 by 1 plus x square dx. So this is tan inverse of x. So compare this. Here we have a square instead of 1. So now you can write using this formula simply. So 1 by a into tan inverse of x by a plus c. So integration of a square minus x square dx, you can write this formula 1 by 2a into log of a plus x by a minus x plus c. So here 1 by x square minus a square dx, here also you can write this formula 1 by 2a log of, here we can write a plus x by a minus x, so here you can write x minus a by x plus a plus c. So next formula, integration of 1 by square root of a square minus x square dx. So we know the formula, integration of 1 by square root of 1 minus x square dx, that is sine inverse of x plus c. So observe it, here we have square root of a square minus x square here and square root of 1 minus x square. Clearly we know that we have a square instead of 1. So you can write the formula sine inverse of x by a plus c. So integration of square root of 1 minus x square dx value is sine inverse of x plus b, c. Integration of 1 by square root of a square minus x square dx value is sine inverse of x by a plus c. Now integration of 1 by square root of a square plus x square dx. So here a square minus x square, here we have a square plus x square. So you can write it as sine h inverse of x by a plus c. Next, here integration of 1 by square root of x square minus a square dx. So observe it, a square minus x square sine inverse of x by a square plus x square sine h inverse of x by a, but it is x square minus a square, so this is cos h inverse of x by a plus c. So using the formula integration of 1 by square root of 1 minus x square dx, that is equal to sine inverse of x plus c, using this formula you can write these three formulas. So now you can write seventh formula, integration of square root of a square minus x square dx. So you can write this formula using the fourth formula, integration of 1 by square root of a square minus x square dx. So first of all you can write x by 2 into same square root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into, so observe it, integration of square root of a square minus x square dx. So same formula, integration of 1 by square root of a square minus x square dx equals to sine inverse of x by a. So here we can write sine inverse of x by a plus c. So integration of square root of a square plus x square dx, so same right, x by 2 into square root of a square plus x square plus a square by 2. Here integration of 1 by square root of a square plus x square dx value is sine h inverse of x by a, right, sine h inverse of x by a plus c. Now the ninth formula, integration of square root of x square minus a square dx, right, x by 2 into square root of same x square minus a square plus, sorry, plus, not plus, it is minus, because 1 by square root of x square minus a square value cos h inverse of x by a. So here we get minus a square by 2 cos h inverse of x by a plus c. So these are the 9 standard formulas.